Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Chuntura here. And welcome to a gloriously sunny 20 degrees here in the UK. I think this must have been one of the first sunny days of the year so far. One or two wispy clouds, no prospect of rain, and we'll take the opportunity to get out on the bike as usual. I've done all the pre-flight checks, tire pressure, oil and all that business. And of course a cursory glance of the fuel gauge will tell you that we've got 4/5 of a tank, and the trip computer is telling us we've got a range of 259 miles. Although rumour has it that there's a parts sale on in Stevenage, so you may need some spirited riding to get there and beat all the sports bike boys. Just my little Jake there. Everyone knows you're never going to beat a sports bike boy to a sale of parts. Rather refreshing breeze with the vents on the upper arms opened. So it looks as though I may be heading off to parts foreign and rather warm. More on that in due course. But I was just wondering whether any of you had come across suitable climate control riding gear for extremely hot conditions. I mean, obviously you can get heated clothes for cold conditions, and I just wondered whether you could get cooling clothes for hot conditions. Now I know that you can soak your t-shirt and bandana in water before you set off riding, and allow the cooling effect of evaporation to help. But I just wondered whether there were any cooling garments out there. Anyway, if you have heard of such things, drop a comment in the section below. In the meantime, I'll continue my research on Tinternet. there's sometimes a speed camera van sits along just here to catch you coming into the 30 mile an hour. But I don't think he's there. Normally sits on that grass verge. Which rather suggests he might be somewhere else today. They can be sneaky so-and-sos, can't they? Doing waving to a Harley guy. So what was that sign? Didn't look like he was scratching his back. And it wasn't the middle finger.